Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right. Praise the living God. I just wanted to make a quick video, brothers and sisters. Praise God Almighty. You know that God is just so awesome, brothers and sisters. He's beyond awesome. You know, I just have so many different things that the Lord's been showing me. But I wanted to tell you this about our Lord Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. In Hebrew, the Bible says that there is no other name under heaven given to men where we might be saved. That is the name above all names, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So brothers and sisters, next time people start talking and naming those names of God from the Old Testament, all the different names that I just mentioned it in the video the other day, these are attributes and revelations that God gave to a man. I think it's all men in there that he gave a revelation to in the Old Testament about himself. And then they gave a name to it, like, El Shaddai is the name that God gave to Abraham, God Almighty. Not a name of God, but a place, you know, when Jacob was fleeing from his brother because his brother was plotting to kill him because he stole his birthright and stole his blessing. He conned him out of his birthright and stole his blessing as the firstborn son. As Jacob was fleeing, he spent the night and he slept with his head on a rock. And the place is called Luz before. But in that place, Jacob slept on the rock, and then he had a dream, or he had a vision, a night vision of these angels ascending and descending there. And so he set up a pillar to God and put oil on it, and he named the name of the place Beth-El, House of God. You know, and Jacob said, surely God is in this place, and I didn't know it. You know, not like God is everywhere, right? You know, but, you know, his revelation was God is in this place. You know, that's why he called it Beth-El, House of God. Just like Beth, you can learn a few Hebrew words if you put your mind to it. Bethlehem is house of bread. Jesus is the bread of life, born in Bethlehem. Also the city of David, you know, born this day in the city of David. Christ the Savior, hallelujah, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Born in the house of bread, Bethlehem and Beth-El, house of God. God bless you guys. I just want to tell you that, you know, there's so many things that the Lord has been talking to me about. Some of the things I've talked about in the past. You know, all of these things that we might be led by the Lord to talk about. What's the right word? I'm excited, brothers and sisters, because I know God's going to do something. Of course, we believe that, of course, the rapture is very close. Even besides that, brothers and sisters, God's going to do something. Let's just say that God is going to do something wonderful today. You know, America has fallen a long way, brothers and sisters. And the thing about it is, God's not going to let it keep falling. That's the point. Either A, which of course I believe it's going to be the rapture of the church and the tribulation, but either the rapture and the tribulation is going to happen, or God's going to send revival. He's not going to let America keep going the way that it's going. Judgment or revival, God is going to send to the United States. He's going to not let his children suffer, you know, begging for bread in the street, as the Bible says. You know, I haven't seen the children of God, you know, begging for bread in the street. God's not going to let that happen to his church. Because, let me just say this. This is truth. Right now, in this wicked world in which we live, brothers and sisters, there is only one thing standing in the between the total abyss of darkness and worldwide dictatorship and totalitarianism. And a halfway decent world where children and families can live a normal life. That's the church. The remnant of the church. The salt and light that's in this world. Now, There are Christians all over the world. As a matter of fact, there's been an explosion of revival in lots of countries of Christians. You know, birth of millions of people getting born again, and then millions and millions of people. As a matter of fact, the biggest move in the world is, you know, among the Pentecostal churches, Assemblies of God, and all these other groups all throughout South America and all these places, and China and all these places, brothers and sisters. But there's one country that has a lot of born-again Christians, and of course has the military might, a superpower of the world. There's only one country in the position to bring freedom and democracy to the world that's been in this world. That's the United States. And this age that we've been living in, brothers and sisters, these last days. So that's why America is in that exceptional position, just as Israel was before, back in the days of King Solomon and all that. They were in that unique position to bring the light of the God of Israel to the world. And now America has been in that same unique position the last 100, 200 years. Number one producers of missionaries and Bibles, preachers, seminaries, all the things, all the, you know, the latest teachings and understandings and restorations, like the Pentecostal movement from out there in Los Angeles, the Azusa Street Revival, all these things. So we're on the precipice of revival or rapture. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Things are moving. God's going to move the situation. Like I say, no man knows the day or the hour of the rapture. It seems that everything's coming together. All the signs, we know that, for the rapture to be imminent, brothers and sisters. But if the rapture doesn't happen at this time, and the Lord is going to... Because, brothers and sisters, I just want to caution you, and I've said, you know, and I'm usually on the air on the side of caution, okay? I just want to caution you again and say that what St. Peter told us in his book that he wrote in the Bible, he said, God is not slack, you know, like we are. God's not lazy, God's not slack, but he wishes none to perish, but all people to come to repentance, to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. So the Lord delays. He's been delaying his judgment. He's been delaying. He's been tearing and been delaying. How many times? You know, so it's only God knows if the fullness of times has come. Even though it seems like it, even though that's, you know, what I think I'm hearing from the Lord in my spirit and all that. But I'm only a man, and any of you, we're only humans. We see through a glass darkly, the Apostle Paul said. You know, we see, each of us see, you know, a little piece. Some people see a little bit better than others. That's true. But we all see through a glass darkly, brothers and sisters. I want to tell you, though, the good news is that if you're a true Christian, we should rejoice. Not in the day of the Lord, not in judgment, not in tribulation. We should rejoice, of course, in the rapture. But we should also even more rejoice if God would stay his hand one more time and send revival one more time to the United States and to the world, of course. You know, almost all the Christian television, all that, even there's lots of junk on Christian television, almost all of that stuff is coming out of the States, brothers and sisters. It's based, even though there's lots of junk on TBN, the network is there, TBN and TCT and Daystar and all those networks. They got a little bit of good stuff on there. Let's say it's 90% junk. But listen to me, brothers and sisters. God can light a fire under the behinds of those people. You know, he could open a door for people that preach like me and whomever else. I know there's other people in the world that's preaching correct, righteous, holiness, repentance, and the power of God. Not to be consumed on our own lust, but signs and wonders following the gospel, repentance and revival and all those things. God can supernaturally invade those networks and make a way for those people to start preaching right, or send people like me and others like me who will preach boldly on those networks. And then that gospel, you know, those like TBN and all them, they go into like billions of homes around the world, brothers and sisters. God can send revival like that. God could turn this thing around like that. You know, God can change Obama's heart even if he wanted to. Boom, like that. Nothing's impossible for God. That's why I get upset when I see people talking about this, that, and the other. And God alone is on the throne. God alone is on the throne. And God only uses his true prophets to pronounce his judgment. Not their judgment, but his judgment. Lots of people making proclamations and pronouncements. God didn't call them. And they even expose themselves by saying things that contradict the word all the time. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Go read your New Testament and learn the basic outline of the way God operates in the New Testament and grace and all that, and hold that up against 90% of the people that you've been listening to with all this nonsense, and you will see that what they're saying is not lining up with the Word of God, brothers and sisters. Praise God, praise God. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so many different things I want to tell you. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I can't stop. I just can't stop praising his name. You know, that's a song too. I just can't stop praising the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. For he's a holy God. He's a holy God. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, we praise you. For you are our master and we are your servants. Father, right now, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord, we come before you right now, Lord. Lord, your word says that the deeds of our heart, Lord God, would be exposed and be seen before you, Lord, on that day of the judgment seat of Christ, Lord. Oh, Father, forgive us of our sins in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, purge us with hyssop, Lord God. Cleanse us, Lord God, by your holy blood, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we just declare right now and decree, Lord God, that we believe your word, that your word is truth, Lord. And you said if we confess our sins, you are just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. 1 John 1:9, Lord God. Father, we thank you for thy word. For even as the Lord Jesus Christ said, thy word is truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father, creator of heaven and earth, Lord, who loved us so much that you gave your only begotten Son, Lord. And Father, he said that anybody that believes in him would not perish but have everlasting life. Praise God for the truth spoken by the truth, the way and the life, our Lord and Savior, your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you, Lord. Lord, I ask you, Lord, just to pour out your grace and your wisdom and your mercy upon all of your children, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord. Lord, for I know you delight in thy children, Father. Your delight is in your children, Lord God. Oh, Lord, we praise you, Lord God. We praise you to the uttermost, Lord God. Father, thou art worthy. You are worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah. Bless you, Heavenly Father. Bless you, mighty God. Hallelujah. Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. Hallelujah. From everlasting to everlasting. Thy love endureth forever. Hallelujah, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you for the plan you gave of salvation. Oh, we thank you, Father, hallelujah, that you planned this all from the foundation of the world. Father, we thank you that we're part of your plan, that we've been chosen, called, and set apart, hallelujah, for such a time as this. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And Lord, that you are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we can ask or think, Father. So, Father, we just come before you right now in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Father, we say, here we are. Send us. As Isaiah said, Isaiah chapter 6, here we are, Father, send us. Here we are, Father, use us. Here we are, Father, divide us from the tares. Lord, separate us and set us on a high hill. Set us apart, Lord God, for your work, Lord God. Meet for the master's use. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I hear a word from the Lord. Time shall be no more, says the Lord. Hallelujah. No more delay, says the Lord. shaken, says the Lord. Shaken is the powers of this earth. Hallelujah. I set at naught those things that think they are, says the Lord. Hallelujah. I'll cause a stir. I'll cause a stir to begin at the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. This is the word I'm hearing from the Lord. I shall take a wrecking ball to the structures of mankind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A wrecking ball. Father, we give you the praise. I just hear the Lord saying this will be a sign. It's a sign. And I see this bird flying away. And it's a sign. I guess it's talking about the rapture. I'm not sure. Father, we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, brothers and sisters, I just made this message about God might send revival, but I just got that word from the Lord. It's time to be no more. So, hey, well, you know, I tried. I tried, brothers and sisters. I've tried to pitch one more for the Gipper. You know, I tried to, you know, I mean, I was just making sure, brothers and sisters. I'm just confirming and making sure because I'm always open by the grace of God to do revival. And I, you know, and I was going to talk about revivals when I started this video. The mighty moves of God I've seen in the Philippines, even in the Filipinos in Greensboro, North Carolina. Mighty move of God. Revival, I'm talking about something like, I mentioned it a little bit before, something like you'd have to see it to believe it. You have to experience a real move of God when the Spirit of God falls afresh on His people. I'm talking about life-changing, life-altering, being caught up to heaven, seeing angels, seeing the Lord, all that by the hundreds of people. Having encounters with God, healings without nobody praying for them. Demons manifesting in the lost people in the crowd and using, you know, a whole team of pastors to minister to the people and cast out the demons. I've talked about it a little bit before. Revival is awesome, brothers and sisters, but seems as if, though, every time I talk to the Lord about it, keeps confirming that, you know, let's roll. You know, it's time to roll. Roll on home, brothers and sisters. Back to our heavenly home. This world is not our home, brothers and sisters. God bless you all. You know, I get praise reports, too. I wanted to mention that while I'm thinking about it. I get praise reports probably at least once a week, brothers and sisters. I very rarely have only talked about it once or twice of people, you know, who I gave a word to the Lord. You know, if you go back and look at the videos, if you didn't know, I made these videos on my channel, Words for Those Who Ask. Vast, vast majority of the people put down comments, you know, how the word was really from the Lord. I gave people words that came to pass about all kinds of even financial blessings that were coming. Or I just got one today from a sister whose husband is a doctor, and she had used the anointing oil, and she had something in the back of her head. They said there wasn't nothing wrong with her, but she put that oil on there, and there was a little piece of metal that actually was coming out of her head where it was hurting, where she had had a previous surgery that they couldn't find or couldn't see and couldn't find. And her husband's even a doctor. But I hear those things all the time, brothers and sisters. I guess before I used to watch Christian television, and they have some healings on there, and I guess every show they're tooting their horn about how God used them to heal somebody. Of course, it's great to give testimony, to have testimonies, but I don't usually mention it at all. But, you know, I was talking to, as a matter of fact, Brother Gary and I was talking about that. And Brother Gary's going to make some videos when he gets a chance about some of the things miracles and things like that, that we've experienced. But it's just like this, brothers and sisters. You know, a lot of people, you know, get faith by hearing about other people's testimony of being healed and things like that. So it's good to have those things too. It's part of, it's also giving honor and glory to God, as they say, when someone has a testimony, it builds up other people's faith. But I'll just say that I get at least one testimony a week, brothers and sisters. Back when I was doing crusades in the Philippines, you know, it'd be hundreds of people, and then people healed by the hundreds, brothers and sisters, you know. And then, you know, God has lots of people like that, you know, that are hidden, you know. It's not like those people you see on TBN, even though God uses some of them. But, you know, the people that God uses are usually like anonymous only to the Lord and the people they prayed with. You know, I'm reminded of the story of Jesus. You know, he healed the 12 lepers, and only one of them came back and praised God and thanked him for praying with for them. Of the 12 lepers, one of them was from Samaria. And 12 were healed, and only one was praising God and thanking Jesus for healing him. And that's true, brothers and sisters. Pray with people all the time that were healed, and they just go on with their life. And just, it's not even that they even praise the Lord. They don't thank the Lord. They don't even say, hey, you know, Pastor Patrick, you pray for me and I got healed. Praise God, you know, or nothing. Very few. And this is the way it is. It's just the way it is, brothers and sisters. So that's why, you know, when you see these people on TV, they're touting and stuff. But God's healing people all over the place. God's doing miracles all the time through people. It's just that, you know, it's just not, it's anonymous. It's not known to everybody. That's how it is with God. You know, sometimes for his purposes, though, he will make it broadcasted. And that, but lots of times, you know, it's not. You know, that person knows, and maybe the right people that hear it will be saved or whatever. They will know about it. That's how God operates, brothers and sisters. Anyway, God bless. I just wanted to come on here and I have so many more things to tell you. I just got to break it down and do it a video at a time. Just put it out there piece by piece. God bless you guys.